folks, we are finishing up the bones of our shoulder or our pectoral girdle. So previously we looked at the clavicle, and now we're going to be looking at the scapula, which is this bone here. The scapula is commonly referred to as the shoulder bone or shoulder blade, I guess, more often. Again, remember, in addition to being able to label this as the scapula and being able to identify the different structures of the scapula, you also need to be able to identify left and right. So let me show you that this is a left scapula. I'm holding it in my left hand. It is positioned in the body this direction, but more correctly, we can see it this way. Okay, so this is the anterior view. This is the posterior view. Most of the features we need to see, you can see from this view. This is the easiest view to see in the body. So this is usually your reference point for this bone. Here, this is where the humeral head is going to articulate. This is the socket for the ball and socket joint of the shoulder. And so this is going to be lateral because your arm is sticking out to the side, not coming out the middle of your back. Okay. And so then this is also the top, and this is the bottom. And most of the structures of our scapula are named based on direction. So what I actually like to do is to trace around my bone here. So to begin, this socket for the shoulder joint is called the glenoid cavity, glenoid fossa, or you can call it the lateral angle. Glenoid cavity, glenoid fossa, or lateral angle. Coming down from that, this whole edge of the bone is called the lateral border. Yeah, lateral border. Double checking myself. Okay. This point here at the bottom is called the inferior angle. Then we have the medial border and the superior angle. And then right here, we have the superior border. Now notice in line with the superior border, we have a process here. This is the process that we see also connecting or touching here with our glenoid cavity or fossa. This right here is called the coracoid process. So see, it's in the same plane as our superior angle, superior border, and then the coracoid. This is the only thing in the body called coracoid, okay? So let's trace it again. Glenoid cavity, fossa, or lateral angle, lateral border, inferior angle, medial border, superior angle, superior border, coming right in line with the coracoid process. From the coracoid process, jump over to the acromion process, and then trace your finger down the spine. Now we're going to name three fossae. A fossa, that's our singular version of the word, is a depression in bone. We have a depression above the spine, so we're going to call this depression the supraspinous fossa. We have a depression below the spine, so we're going to call that the infraspinous fossa. And then if you go back to the anterior view, we have a fossa here, and this is called the subscapular fossa. And that's it for the scapula.